Honorable President of India, senior dignitaries, commandant, and members of NDC faculty, ladies and gentlemen, I am Air Commodore Arun Saklani of the Indian Air Force. It is a singular honor for all of us to interact with the Supreme Commander of India's Armed Forces this morning. As senior officers of the India's three services, civil services, and our friends from foreign countries, the NDC course gave us an opportunity to interact with some of the best scholars and experts in the country from various walks of life. This included leading politicians, intellectuals, senior bureaucrats, ambassadors, serving and retired senior armed forces officers, and leading media personalities. We also had an opportunity to listen to a number of distinguished visitors from abroad. Our study tours within the country provided us with an understanding of various aspects of governance, economic security, socio-political environment, and capabilities of various organizations, both in the public and private sector. Our study tours abroad gave us an understanding of the other nations' best practices and the high place that India stands in relation to advanced and developing countries. The areas we need to concentrate on to realize our full potential, to further enhance the positive image that India enjoys in the community of nations, was evident. As a result of the well-balanced and structured curriculum at the NDC course, we have been able to gain a fresh outlook and understand the nuances of the strategy formulation in the changing global environment that we live in today. This year at NDC has re-inculcated our faith and pride in India's past, its achievements, and our manifest destiny as a great nation. The college provided us with an excellent platform and a great learning environment. Most importantly, the bonding and bonhomie that we have developed with our coursemates from civil services and those from friendly foreign countries is one of the best takeaways from this wonderful year that we have spent at the NDC. While our country has taken great strides in all spheres of growth, all of us realize that our continued hard work and dedication are essential to ensure that the challenges facing the nation continue to be addressed optimally. Issues of governance, poverty eradication, steadfast adherence to the rule of law, and security against external and internal threats need to continue to be our focus areas. And we assure you, Honorable President, sir, that we would pursue these goals in our careers ahead. We thank you once again for this unique honor and privilege to be at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Jai Hind. I now request Sri Rizvi IAS to continue with the proceedings.
Honorable President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovindji, ladies and gentlemen, it is a privilege for me to have been given the opportunity to speak about my experience as a participant of the 59th course of the National Defence College. It is one of the rare programs where senior officers of Indian military and civil services come together to jointly explore strategic security concerns of the nation and identify possible ways to address them. The presence of officers from various friendly foreign countries who bring valuable experiences of their nations in addressing challenges similar to our own further enriches the program. The college provided me a remarkably wide canvas ranging from socio-political and economic matters to international and domestic security environment. The unique curriculum of the college enabled me to learn from leading academicians, policymakers, military experts, diplomats, not only from our own country, but also from abroad. Some of the most important inputs of the program are the carefully designed study tours to various military and economic installations within the country and abroad, the like of which are not available in any other training program in the country. The overseas study tours in particular provided us the opportunity to interact with senior policymakers and military leaders of the countries that we visited, facilitating a two-way exchange of ideas and knowledge. Therefore, apart from being a training institute, the National Defence College also serves as an important tool of diplomacy for the country. Apart from all of the above, I can say without hesitation that one of my most important sources of learning during the last 1 year have been my course mates. Furthermore, on a personal level, I have formed bonds of friendship with people like I haven't formed in decades. These bonds and fond memories of happy times spent in the company of cherished friends will last me a lifetime. I would like to thank the Commandant, faculty and staff of NDC for having facilitated my learning over the course of the last 1 year in the National Defence College. Thank you, sir, for this privilege provided to me at the historic Rashtrapati Bhavan. I will now request Brigadier T.S. Sally of the Sri Lankan Army to share his experiences. Thank you, sir.
Sri Ramnath Kovind, Honorable President of the Republic of India, distinguished high-ranking officials, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. I'm Brigadier Suresh Sale from Army of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. I'm deeply honored and humbled to be addressing this August gathering on behalf of 24 foreign officers from 21 friendly countries attending 59th course at the National Defense College, and to convey our gratitude and sincere appreciation to Honorable President for giving us this opportunity to express our thoughts. I wish to mention that the course of the study which have followed during the past 11 months at the National Defense College, Delhi, is of great importance to all foreign participants who are beneficiaries of this valued opportunity. As we remains this journey of 47 weeks, we were exposed to an array of factors, parameters, issues, situations and aspirations affecting national security. The course curriculum focused on various threat conceptions, opportunities and strategies, and all these have added great value to our knowledge, skills and development. Our extensive study tours to different states of Republic of India offered us a unique opportunity to experience diversity as well as rich heritage of this great nation. It's our valued observation that today India has grown, expanded and developed into a power to reckon with and plays a leading role in the international fora. We wish to express our appreciation to Honorable President and the Government of Republic of India for giving us the opportunity to participate at the National Defence College 59 course. We are also grateful to the Commandant, members of faculty and all other staff of National Defence College for their valued contribution and support. Honorable President, sir, through this course, we not only acquired the knowledge, but we have also developed a strong friendship with officers of Indian Armed Forces and Civil Services. I'm confident that this great stance of friendship will grow in the years ahead, developing into a new vista. Sir, as we leave shores of India, completing the course, the knowledge and the bonds of friendship will continue in the years ahead. As I conclude, let me take this opportunity once again to express our gratitude and sincere appreciation to the Government of India for organizing this valued course and for our privileged visit to Rashtrapati Bhavan. Thank you, sir.